What are y'all looking at?
Nothing.
Fine then. Back to work. Bound 260 wants his responses confirmed by Fickle and Grisham tonight.
Did they make it
okay?
In time? What's going on?
Okay? What's going on?
Hey guys, shut it! Why don't you just ask them when they get here yourselves? Huh? Get away from my desk. I'm trying to do my work. Is that okay?
Very funny, guys. Very funny.
Sorry, I couldn't resist, man. Hello, Josh, Pickle, Jamie, what can I do for you boys?
You having trouble reading the report again? It's Fickle, the F makes a sound as in-
Leave it, man. Lawrence, cut the crap and open the doors. Special D wants to see us.
Go right on in.
Sit down, gentlemen.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, James. So I understand Mr. Summers is being taken into custody. He's going to be questioned. Along with that,
You mean his captor, Mr. Japrick?
Yeah, him. He's going to be put under heavy interrogation and under high surveillance.
Of course. We sent him to the detention facility before we came up here, sir.
Very good.
Will that be all, sir?
No. Quite the contrary.
I've just received word that an old friend is back in business. He goes by the alias of Starence. I'm sure, James, you remember.
So, the bastard finally got out of jail.
Not in the way you think. He escaped just a few months ago. When you bust him for his underground gang ops, he gained a bad reputation with the criminal underworld. And now he's trying to regain his respect. He's got a lot of loyal friends.
Damn, this guy still has bitches? Outside of jail.
He has some dangerous friends. But you two are the best fit for the job. These aren't your run-of-the-mill drug smugglers. These are fresh, imported New York killers, if you know what I mean.
Always do.
Sources say he's got a warehouse in the industrial outskirts of Toronto. It's disguised as an innocent windows and door manufacturer. There's supposed to be some kind of rendezvous there. I need you two to see if you can get these guys.
We're on it.
Good luck, gentlemen. And good work. Drop that shit out. These old punk ass bitches know how we running this shit. Niggas ain't going back to court, you stank ass bitches. I'm stuck in jail, the DA trying to burn me out, but y'all don't bail. If I had a good attorney, wanna label me a criminal, would cuff me up. Got a pocket full of money, so they rough me up. I ain't tripping in the county, and I'm mad as fuck. Got a record, so they put me with the baddest bunch. Everybody wanna talk, cause I'm rapping. They asking me what happened, is it true you did a flick with Janet Jackson?
Send more pictures and make me
some more riches. To all the suckers on the block talking shit while I was locked up. Be prepared to get sucked up, cause the game is deep and the fame is brief. And you bullshitting bitches ain't changing me. I came straight up out the gutter, I was saved from hell. And I'm a thug, I was raised in jail. Now I'm out on bail. You know what fucking time it is. I'm stuck in jail, mad as a bitch, I'll be out on bail. If it wasn't for the snitch, running wild through the streets like I'm loco. And fuck the punk police and they choke hoes. I got no love in my heart cause I'm heartless. Mobbing in the park after dark when it starts shit. Ripping up the scene as a teen, I was at it. Hey, I sell a product to the addicts cause they gotta have it. I was a well-known thug and I got a lot of love. Hanging out with the OG, shooting up the clubs. And mama told me, don't hang with the homies.
Hello! 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 Oh, my friend, it has been too long.
Oh, you look like you just came back from the dead.
Nah, he looks all right for a guy that's been in the slammer for 10 years.
All right, enough of this, guys. What did you bring us here for?
Two words, my friends. Reformation and revenge.
For what? Some of us even have our own businesses now. And some of us have even gone legit.
You don't expect me to believe that, do you? Come on. I know you all have that little box of automatics you sell here and there. Don't think I didn't listen to the news while I was tying soap to my wrists. You guys aren't legit at all. You're just not getting caught.
Sure, that's because we've been keeping things on a down low. We're gradual.
Are you saying that I wasn't discreet? That I didn't try and keep things on the down low, as you guys say these days? I got an offer for you. I have a new furniture shipment coming in soon. I'm sure you'll like what you see underneath the cushions.
What sort of items are you talking about, Stare? Pistols? They're all the rage with the kids.
Oh my God! You're joking, right? You guys still dealing small money with these teens? Shit! I thought you guys were better than that.
Well, it keeps us out of trouble, buddy. Our operations are too small to track down.
Ooh, little Timmy's scared of the big, bad cops. Bullshit, man! I'm not talking about pistols, dude. I'm gonna do accommodate the gangs of this big city. Big gangs means big money. Once we get that shipment of AK-47s in, we're sleeping in beds of cash.
I don't know, man. The gangs don't like tainted business. You got a bad record after you got busted by that Grisham guy.
I have a feeling old Terrence here took that to heart. So what's the catch?
A new supplier. He's good. Met him in Buffalo and he's coming to live here. You get these guns a dime a dozen from our communist triad buddies in good old Asia.
Looks like the perfect criminal.
Looks like a terrorist.
Be at the ports in 2 weeks' time with your generous donations. And I'll be more than happy to refurnish your homes. This is Anita. She'll make sure everything goes as planned. No funny business, kiddies. Or I'll personally make sure that you're buried in closed caskets.
Hello, boys.
I wouldn't worry about security too much, my friends. We'll take care of everything. Oh, look at the time. Come, Anita. Let's leave these respectable men to their business.